It's a Friday, baby! And boy, am I excited. And it's, of course, a very cold day. For all of you who are in Kampala, you know how it, you know, from morning till now, it's been raining. But that's besides the point. Nothing is going to take away my ray of sunshine. Not this Friday. No, oh, no. Hey, welcome to Scoop and Scoop. And it's the final episode of this week. But yeah, I got you next week too. Azazan is that. Welcome. And given the fact it is a Friday, yes, get yourself a copy of the Kampala Sun, and we're going to be delving into what's happening there. Anyway, their headline is Judith Babirye pregnant? I was like, wait, what? 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 And apparently a doctor comes in and as an expert and he goes like, she has all the signs, says the doctor. I'm like, Nayama na Uganda, mutuleke. How did you tell she was pregnant? Were you there when they were laying her to get pregnant? Huh? Huh? I don't get it. I don't. And then comes up the big conspiracy now. This is the conspiracy. Like, did they get married because she was pregnant, or did they get married because they were in love? I think both are the same. You grow to love someone after having kids with them, innit? With time. Anywho, and then, as I'm still going on with that, someone, like, picked my mind about something. It was like, wait, so Judith Babirye, that means she is what? She is, a Mulongo. Nakato Babirye. She happens to be getting married or married to a Ssaalongo. I'm just asking, is it allowed to? Regardless of where they are from. Because someone is like, Judith Musoke, Gai Muchi. Biko Atagana. So is it allowed? Because most people are saying it's taboo. I'm like, who cares? These guys are not dealing with taboo. These guys are not dealing with your sentiments towards life as Africans. They're dealing with their hearts and God. That is all they need. So if God put it together, let no man lay asunder, period. We're not going to even shout about that, but if she is pregnant, I am actually happy for her. Did she have any kids with Niwo? She did? She managed to keep them out of the sight, or like public eye, right? So even it's a good thing. It's a good thing, people. Let's let her enjoy. Enjoy for a minute, because I know there's going to be a lot of drama ahead. So I don't want to catch feelings on this small drama. You can't catch feelings on this. 6 months. Other than that, Kongs, if she's pregnant, yeah, is it blue or red? No, wait, what are the baby colors? Blue or pink? Anyway, kasogetwogera kuba podium today there in Arua. Yes. Zari did show up. I'm supposed to be saying nice things because, in case you don't know, as much as we have our issues with Brian White, he still loves him some New Vision. So we are his official TV, what? Coordination, sponsors, what are we? All I know, he paid us a truckload of money. But yeah, I'm not there. Anywho, they're in Arua today. I was watching the whole situation down in Arua and I'm like, man, there's a lot I can say, and then there's a lot I don't think I even want to say. Because whenever I see Brian White, he is the owner of the foundation. Na ye ya situka, ya duka, ya yamba de simanya dogo tagzi, ya yamba de... It's like, wait, aren't you the Brian White? It's like walking into an Apple store and then you'd find Steve Jobs there wearing his Kapla card. Hi, I'm Steve Jobs and I work for Apple. He's the driver. Aganye, Range Rover, yeto wali ya jivuga ya jivuga, which is understandable. I mean, duh. Anywho, Zari finally made it. Yeah, her passport was cleared. Ah, I'm trying to say nice things. Ah, what money won't do to people? I have no kind words for Brian White. I'm looking at the whole thing and it, for me, it doesn't even feel like a charity thing at all. It's more of like a campaign. I'm still watching the footage meanwhile as I'm working. Wait, is that Zari? Oh my goodness, she looks like a Musambwa. I'm just saying. I like how she's trying to be though. I like how she's trying to be like respectful. She's greeting people well. She didn't pull out her favorite Lulu's hair. She's
She's dressed decently. Something pink. Is that pink or organza? Can't tell. Anywho, that's happening. But yo, let's talk about the podium. Apparently, Gundi Bam go back to podium. Bamitani, Moka Moka, King Michael. Now, from what I know about Brian White and King Michael, they have known each other for way, way too long. As in Bayaye, Bahabiba, Da, they were like tight from the jump. So, the whole story went, before they all went to Arua, is Brian White asked Michael to get into the van, just like the rest of the foundation guys. That's, of course, the Alex Mohanjis, the Big Eyes, the, all those Wololos were all in vans. He bought vans and he's like, that's what we're going to use to go to Arua. The thing, though, is that Michael, because I think he feels he is much more of a friend to Brian White, he goes like, Ned dance, njangala gende na mutundra. I was like, wait, what? Michael, what did you say? He said he wanted to go in the tundra. So Brian White, at that particular moment, the people who are there, because I had my journals there, they were like, yo, Brian White actually told him, Michael, DJ Michael was like, no, I want the tundra. He's like, sebo mfukamide tata, olinye. I can't believe that. Nina sente zangene mfukamiza. And he went ahead, na afukamida. Ya afukamide. And still, we afukamida. Michael is like, nah, nah, nah. So what happens the next day? They had a football match, and this guy just kept quiet. So Michael came, they played soccer together. And after the soccer match, because, I mean, it was a good match for them, he asks, ania zene Michael? Ania zene King Michael? He had paid him 10 million for his upcoming concert. And Michael had only used 1 million. So what does Brian White do? He's like, okay, wako seza kakakadekamu omwenda gumpe. I'm like, what? What? But I don't think Bamgobio ku podium. I just think it's more of like trying to discipline him because yamulagezala wonga abantu bewebali. So who cares, man? It's the Brian White Foundation. It's so much rubbish going on. So much. Baba Cool's concert is today. Yeah, we are going to be in a dome partying, partying. So my producer told me, no, but Tina, do you know what? The Baba Cool is the only artist who could actually make it to the top, what, 100? Top 100, and you'd have a song almost every after one. Two songs? 100 songs, like, down. So I was tasked with, how many songs do you want me to mention, Baba Cool? 50? Hell no, I don't know that many songs of Baba Cool. Let me start. Song number one, what was one of his best songs? I'm going to start with the Agenze album, first of all, because that album was just life. Woo, child! That album had from the moment he broke up with her to when she left, to what the saucepans in the house were doing, to when she came back, to when she was home, to when she was having kids. Like, that album was, woo! That album was life. But the thing, though, I wanted him to do a Akomiewo album. Then when she came back, Akami didn't do one. But that was a good selling album, though. That was a good album. It was the last time he actually really, really put his heart out there. Okay, of course, Love You Every Day was... So we have Love You Every Day, Agenze, the full album. And then we have Freedom. Actually, the Love You Every Day, wasn't it the Love You Every Day album? That's the album that Apis wrote. It's a Friday, it's the beginning of the month, so I know most of you gotten paid. Do not forget, do not drink and drive. If you're going to have... Apis, send your sandals to Baba Cool's concert just to rub it in, buy a table. No tables are guau. Now if he spends 5 million buying a table, what will he use to shoot his other videos? Ne PR wa Gayo na ganye, PR wa Brian White aganye. Kati dabazadi, dabazadi. Ngo geze mikono. Oh, she looks like Michael Jackson in that shot. I swear she looks like Michael Jackson. Remember like when Michael Jackson used to have the palm done really good and the white in the face? Oh, I'm sorry. Wait, I was supposed to say bye. Okay. It's been my time. I'm out. Catch you next week. Peace. Muko muko, eh, muko muko, nyambombe mwanyoko, is that what he says? You were mchiga for a reason. We can hear you. Your cheap Chinese phone is making a lot of noise for me. I'm on set. Thank you.